guys. What's going on? Welcome to a terrific Thursday. Fabulous Thursday. Thursday. What are you going to do? So, one of my favorite Naruto openings. Love it. All right, guys, short video today. Going to give you an assignment to do today. We're going to go over it tomorrow. But we're just going to do a little bit of practice today on filling in function tables. So we talked a little bit about tables the last couple of videos, about setting up an XY table. So let me get these screens set up here, and then we'll get rolling. All right. So tables. XY tables. Just make a T, X, Y. All right. Don't forget Y in function form, or when we're dealing with functions, is oftentimes referred to as F of X. So F of X is the same thing as Y. All right. So we're going to just kind of do, I'm going to show you a few examples of how to fill in a function table. It's really, really simple. And then I'll give you a little bit of an assignment for tonight. So let's pull up this function table here. Or this is just a bunch of function tables. So I'm just going to take a look at the first one. I'll do a couple of these for you guys so you have an idea of what we're talking about here. Let me see if I can blow this up a little bit. There we go. So let's take a look at this first function table here. So we have f of x, which again is the same as y, equals 2x minus 5. All right. So then we have this xy table set up, and we are given a bunch of numbers for x. So what we do is for each x that they give us, so like here they give us 9, right? We're going to substitute 9 for x in our equation up here. And when we solve it, that will give us what f of x is, which is y, right? So again, remember, this is the input-output box here. And what we're going to do is we're going to input numbers to replace x. And then the answer that we get will be our y. Pretty simple. So let's take a look at the first number is 9. So if I replace x with 9, I get 2 times 9 is 18. Minus 5 is 13. So in this box here, I would just put 13. All right. Let's go to the next one. 1. 2 times 1 is 2. And 2 minus 5 is negative 3. Oops. There we go. See what I mean, guys? This is really, really simple. But it's important for dealing with functions. Let's take a look at positive 3. 2 times positive 3 is 6. 6 minus 5 is 1. So we'll put a 1 in the box. Negative 3. 2 times negative 3 is negative 6. Negative 6 minus 5 more is negative 11. So you guys got to be careful with positive and negative signs with these so that you know that you're adding and subtracting correctly. How about 0? Well, 2 times 0 is 0, and 0 minus 5 is minus 5. All right, so that should give you an idea. Let's take a look at another one of these. Let's take a look at this middle one here. Negative 8x plus 8. Okay. So we're going to substitute each of these x values into this equation here where x is. We're going to solve this little equation, and that will give us f of x, which is y. So negative 4, replace x with negative 4, so I end up with negative 8 times negative 4. So we got to be careful here. So negative times a negative is going to be a positive. So negative 8 times negative 4 is positive 32, and then we add 8 more to that, and we get 40. 40. Positive 8. Well, negative 8 times positive 8 is negative 64. And negative 64 plus 8 is going to be negative 56. Right? Yes? 64, 6, 8, Yes. Oof, sorry. Had to think there for a minute. Negative 1. Negative 8 times negative 1 is positive 8. And positive 8 plus positive 8, 16. 0. Well, anything times 0 is 0, and 0 plus 8 is 8. Easy enough. And then finally, negative 7. Negative 7 times negative 8 is positive 56. And 56 plus 8 more. Uh-oh, I got to get my thinking gas. 64. Boom. Okay, excellent. Now, let's do... Let me find one here. Let's take this. Let's take this first one again. And I want to show you something here. So let me get these answers out of the way. Now check out the box. I'm going to change this a little bit. So let's say that instead of 2x minus 5, our equation is 1 third x minus 5. Okay? F of x equals 1 third x minus 5. Okay? So let's use that, and then we're going to use the same numbers they gave us. So we got 9, 1, 3, negative 3, and 0. All right? So take a look at this here. So with a fraction, guys, we're doing the same thing. You just might have to bust out the trusty calculator. So, again, let's do the same thing that we've done. So we're going to replace 9 for x. So what is 1 third times 9? Well, 1 third times 9, and we'll change that to a fraction. We'll put a 1 under it, so that way we can multiply. And then when you multiply fractions, you just multiply straight across. So 1 times 9 is 9. 3 times 1 is 3. And 9 divided by 3 is 3. So 1 third times 9 is 3. And 3 minus 5 is negative 2. Okay? Let's take the next one. What's 1 third times 1? Well, that's just 1. And what is, or 1 third times 1 is 1 third. And 1 third minus 5. So we have 1 third minus 5, which is going to equal, we could change this to a fraction if you wanted to, and we would have 1 third minus 5 over 1, change the denominators to 15, 15 times 5 is, good Lord, well, let's just do it the easy way. If you have 5 and you take away a third, you're left with minus 4 and 2 thirds. Or, I'm sorry, 1 third minus 5. You're taking, if you have 33 cents and you take $5 away from that, you're left in the hole with negative $4.67. So, negative 4.2, negative 4 and 2 thirds. Negative 4, 2 thirds. All right, how about 3? Well, 1 third times 3 is 1, and 1 minus 5 is negative 4. How about negative 3? Negative 3 times 1 third is negative 1, and negative 1 minus 5 more is negative 6. And then 0, 1 third times 0 is 0, and 0 minus 5, negative 5. So all I really wanted to show you guys with that is if it's a fraction, you do the same exact thing. You just might have to bust out a calculator, but no big deal. You still are going to multiply the fraction times whatever this is, subtract the 5, and then you end up with your answer. Okay? So we're going to practice that today. I'm going to post a worksheet for this today so that you guys have an idea of how to do this. Let me show you what the worksheet looks like. Boom. There we go. So what I've done, guys, is I've made this this worksheet easy for you to submit. So a lot of you are just sending me an email with the answers. So this way, since I put the red letters in there, if you wanted to do that, you could. You could just say in an email, A equals this, B equals this, instead of having to do it on the sheet itself. Or you could do it on a separate sheet of paper. Or you could type the numbers into this sheet and email me back the sheet. But you can see here that I've put red letters for the answers. So the first one is a table that we just did, just exactly like we did. You're going to replace X with the numbers that they give you and then come up with Y. And down here at the bottom on B, they give you what X is. In this first case, you can see right here, they're telling us that X is negative 3, right? Because F and then you have X in parentheses. Well, here, instead of X being in the parentheses, they replace that with negative 3. So that's telling us what is X, negative 3. So here, I'm going to replace this X right here with negative 3, and that will give me this answer, F. Okay? Same thing here. Over here, I have negative 7X plus 1. I'm going to replace X with negative 3. So I'm going to end up with negative 7 times negative 3 plus 1. All right? Same thing down here, for example. Here, they're telling us that X is negative 2. So for this and this and this, I'm going to substitute X with negative 2 and put my answer here, here for I, J, and for K. Okay? So that's how you do this table, or these two tables, all right? Pretty simple. We're not doing any graphing. We're just going to do a little bit of practice, making sure that we understand how to fill in a function table. I'm going to go over this tomorrow, which would be Friday. So do what you can. See if you understand it. See if you're able to get all of your answers in correctly. Then you can compare your answers with the answers that I give you guys tomorrow, and then you can turn it in then if you'd like. All right? So guys, have a great rest of the day, and I'll see you tomorrow.